Look, watch carefully at these first three examples as I do them. I will do it very slowly.
Limit as n approaches infinity of n over n minus 1. The point is that we rewrite the limit on the top and bottom. We rewrite the fraction line. On the top and bottom, we factor out the highest powers of n. As for the top, there's only n. So there's nothing to factor out. If there's just one component, you don't factor it out. I leave n, and as for the bottom, I'll play around a bit. The largest powers of n, n. In which power is it the largest here? Only here. Here. Here it's n to the first power, as it were. Here is the largest power of n, right?
In this simple example, I factor it out, which is n, n,
parenthesis. What will it be? How was it done? Watch carefully now.
These two components, this one and this one, I need to divide by what I factored out, which is n. I start the first one. N divided by n will be 1. I already wrote it down. I calculated it in my head. I didn't write n over n. I immediately wrote 1. I rewrite the minus. I rewrite 1 divided by n by what I factored out. And in this way, I get such an expression.
Do you understand? I factor out the highest power of n here. What is it? I write this bracket and divide each of these terms by n.
I calculated this one in my head, but this one I didn't calculate because 1 over n, well, was there to calculate? I wrote down 1 over n.
Do you understand? What did this give me?
Look, n cancels with nn, right? On top, notice there's immediately a 1. There's no 0 on top, nor does the fraction disappear. There's just a 1 on top, right? So this is clear, I think. And what next? Look, what does 1 over n approach? We remember that it approaches infinity. So here we really have 1 over infinity.
N 1 over infinity, from these two basic formulas that I showed you on the previous slide. This is 0, so I know that this approaches 0. This I can replace with 0.
What do we have left in this limit? Look, all the n's disappeared, these disappeared, and this disappeared. So I can already write the result. Notice that without the limit. Here I copied the limit and here I didn't. On the top there will be 1 and on the bottom what?
1 minus 0 because it approaches 0. 1 minus 0 gave 1, so I write 1. 1 divided by 1 equals 1. Notice that here I wrote the limit and here I didn't. Why?
The rule is as long as n is in the expression, as long as conversely, as long as n is in the expression, there is a limit, right? Sure, if n disappears and here it disappeared, then you write without the limit, right? Take a closer look at this slowly.
We'll do this in two more very slow examples, right? It's probably not that difficult.
Now here you understand why it changed to 0, and this disappeared because 1 remained here. Huh? 1 times something is just that something, right?